Welcome, viewers, to this very special program of Talk Time. Today, our topic is discovering our past. When we talk of past, the human civilization is all about evolution and history at various periods. And it is also about documentation and preservation of history. When we talk of preserving our history, comes the study of archaeology. And archaeology is the study of human history through the sites of excavation and artifacts and other physical remains. In our country, it is the Archaeological Survey of India which takes care of all these activities. So viewers, today we have with us the superintending archaeologist of Northeast Guwahati Circle, K. Amarnath Ramakrishna, with us. Welcome to our studio, sir. So when we talk about history and archaeology, they are integrally related. How do you look at it and what's your take on the subject?
First of all, I would like to express my thanks to Doordarshan Guwahati for giving me the opportunity to talk about the heritage of the past and historical importance of the archaeology. You put a well-defined question, what is archaeology and what is the use of it? Archaeology is nothing but the study of human past from their material remains. That is called to be the archaeology. Whatever our ancestor left, their manufactured things are called to be the artifacts. That is, we are calling as a material. They left the material for us to study their story. With that material only, we are reconstructing the entire history of all over the world. We have also constructed so many historical evidence from the archaeological materials, our India's past, from Indus to prehistory as well as protohistory onwards. This is the one among the important subject in the history. History can write with so many sources like literary evidence, oral traditions and numismatics evidence as well as epigraphical evidence. Among them, the primary source is considered to be the archaeological material, is called to be the primary source for writing the history. Without archaeological evidence, we cannot able to reconstruct the history in perfect way. That is my view in this thing.
So you want to say that for mankind to go ahead, archaeology is very important?
Yes, archaeology is very important. With the archaeological evidence, we can easily reconstruct the past. Without any hypothetical views.
Okay.
That can be reconstructed through archaeological evidences. Like stories as well as the literature can give some hypothetical as well as imaginary views. Okay. But that cannot be found in archaeological evidence. What are the material they used in their future time? We are collecting that material and we are describing about the materials. That is the real evidence of the mankind.
Now, as a layman, we are talking about artifacts and physical remains of the past. What are artifacts basically?
Basically, all the materials made by the human being is called to be the artifacts.
Okay.
It may be in stone, it may be in wood, it may be in any kind of material.
Okay.
Which was made by the human being is called to be the artifacts.
Okay.
The artifacts varies from so many things. We can make as artifact like potteries, okay, in stone sculptures, inscriptions, as well as small tools, bone tools, as well as semi-precious objects. We can have as well as metal objects. Everything comes under artifacts.
Okay.
What are the things made by the human being is called to be the artifacts.
Okay. When we speak about archaeology, the main thing is excavation of sites.
Yes,
now, how
yes.
do archaeologists find out that this is the site to be excavated?
Yeah.
What is the criteria behind the selection of an
yes,
site?
Actually, basically, archaeological work starts from the exploration. Exploration means the surveying of the sites.
Okay.
First of all, we are going to select some place to dig. We have to survey entire area,
right,
to find out the site is potentially having archaeological wealth, so we can able to do the excavations.
Right.
So we can physically verifying that exploration in all over the parts. Particularly, we are selecting the river basins. River basins are very important. The river basins where the human origin was started. That river basins we selecting for conducting the explorations. There we physically go through and see entire area, and we find some sites. Within that list of sites, we can choose one among the site, and we will finally decide for the excavation. This is the way.
And you said a very interesting thing that the riverbeds.
Yes.
Basically, all human civilizations were found to be beside the rivers. All the bigger civilizations, even the Indus Valley civilizations and all.
Yeah.
So, would you like to add something to that, like what you were saying?
Yes, yes. Actually, in India, not only in India, all over the world, civilizations are emerged through the riverbanks. The river banks are the perennial water sources for humankind to make agriculture.
Yes.
Human past has shifted their quality of life from hunting gathering to the agriculture-based system.
Agrarian society.
Mm-hmm. The river has main important source for them. So they selected the river valleys and they made a settlements all over the river valleys.
Right.
And so that is why so many river valleys are found all over the world, like Nile, as well as here in Euphrates and Tigris in Egypt, as well as in Indus, as well as Gangetic Valley. We are having so many civilizations all over the world.
And there comes an interesting question, like how do these sites get, you know, covered that it is to be excavated? What is the process?
Basically natural calamity, the sites are covered. It is mainly because of natural. Sometimes it may be mankind due to invasions. A city can be destroyed, so the people can migrate from one place to another.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, the naturally flood as well as earthquake and so many natural calamities are there. That is affecting the human human settlement in abandoned state. So that time they will leave the settlement and shift to other areas.
And in due process it gets covered?
Yes, yes. In natural course of actions, it will due cover time to time and centuries to years together.
So it must be a very cumbersome process, like detecting the site,
yes,
then going for the excavation, then executing the excavation part, and then comes the process of maybe determining a lot of things. Like, can you explain, sir, what's the process like? How do you
an archaeologist can choose a district or a river basin.
Okay.
First of all, he wants to do the work.
Okay.
So most probably we can't do entire river basin.
Okay.
Entire river basin covers more than 1,000 kilometers or hour.
Okay.
It is not at all possible to us to cover the entire area.
Right.
So we can able to cover only the limited area, like district or small river areas.
Okay.
And that basin, we entire river banks were explored in depth. And we select so many sites.
Okay.
We can differentiate the sites. What kind of site? This is a habitation or burial. Mm-hmm. Or we can differentiate the sites. And what is our aim, we will see.
Okay.
Based on that, we can select a site and we can able to do. We want to do a habitation site, means we can select a habitation site and we will do the excavation there. Otherwise, we want burial site, means we select burial site and we can do the excavation at burial.
Right.
This is the system, system we are following in archaeological exploration.
Okay. Now, coming back to this region, or rather getting initiated for this region,
yes,
I'd like to know from you, there are 80 centrally protected monuments in your circle.
Yes.
That is the Guwahati circle of Northeast. And there are tremendous, high value, if I can say, monuments, like the iconic Ranghar, the Karenghar, the Maidans at Charidyo, Sonitpur, Gwalpara district. You know, it's a huge thing to protect all these monuments, keep it preserved, and make it keep it good for the people to visit, and basically to look into our past.
Yes.
Now, and ASI is doing a marvelous job into that. Would you throw some light on these aspects of the Northeast?
For entire Northeast and under Archaeological Survey of India, we are having 80 monuments. In Northeast has been divided into two circles. One functioning from Guwahati, another one is functioning from Aizwal.
Okay.
Guwahati circles comes under the four states: Assam, Nagaland, Arunachal and Meghalaya.
Okay.
The remaining three states, Tripura, Mizoram, Manipur, comes under Aizwal circle.
Right.
We are preserving the monuments well, preserved methods and conserved methods.
Right.
And as well as we are giving these monuments to see the peoples, to understand their value of that monument.
Exactly.
We are, most of the monuments are unticketed monument. Okay. Only five.
Free for the visitors.
Yeah, free for the visitors.
Okay.
Only five monuments are under the control of our circle is a ticketed monument.
Okay.
These are the minimum ticketed amount to give a maintenance for that monument that was levied.
Right. So actually, it is all scattered. You know, the whole of Assam.
Yeah. Yes,
there are so many
yes.
of them. For example, in Upper Assam, as we mentioned, the Rangar. It is a spectacle.
Yes.
It's an iconic thing.
Yes.
Would you say something specific regarding the
actually,
preservation of Rangar?
Yes. Sivasagar is the clutcher of
Sivasagar.
Sivasagar.
Yes.
We can call it as a Sivasagar monument. In Assam, Sivasagar monuments are considered to be the primary monuments of this region.
And it is
The Ahom dynasty was flourished.
Yes.
They constructed so many monumental structures.
And it's a matter of pride for the people of Assam.
In Upper Assam, particularly we can say as Rangar and Talatalgar, as well as Karingar, Ahom, Charaidyo, Vishnudol, Sivudol, in Jaisagar, as well as Sivasagar. So
Absolutely.
Many Gaurisagar.
Mm-hmm.
We are having so many monumental features constructed by particularly by the Ahom kings. That was available in that region. That is why that Rangar monument also considered to be the pride of Assam.
Right.
That has given importance to that monument that once upon a time it was acted as a pavilion to the pub.
And not only Sivasagar, sir, recently we had the privilege of going to Sri Sri Sujapahar and we have done a documentary on that. You know very well about that. And would you throw some, and actually before I get in your comments, I would like to show the viewers the excerpts from that documentary. Let us have a look at the audiovisual.
The Kapila Purana of Hindu text given a reference that two major sun worship sites. One among the sites was the Surya Pahad. Surya Pahar is generally called as a hill of sun. The name generally derived from the sun god worship.
Motivated by the words of Mr. Ramakrishna, I headed to find more about this unique and one-of-its-kind ancient religious confluence point. A place which stands testimony to the rich history of our state. After traveling for about 145 km northwest of Guwahati, we reached the famous town of Goalpara. A short drive of about 15 km north of Goalpara town, and we were at the site we had been eagerly waiting to reach. We were at one of the most famous archaeological sites of Assam, the ancient Sri Sri Hujapahar. Without wasting any time and extremely excited to find more, I started to explore the place all by myself. It is undoubtedly a unique and one of its kind spot in the middle of a vast stretch of land nestled in the lap of the mighty Hujapahar or Sun Hill. Sri Sri Hujapahar is very significant but is relatively a lesser known archaeological site in Goalpara district of Assam. a hill which preserves within itself the remains of cultural heritage of three important religions of India, Buddhism, Jainism and Hinduism.
Welcome back, viewers. Now, as you've seen the visuals, basically, it speaks a lot about the work of Archaeological Survey of India in various areas, and especially Sri Suryapar, which is in Gwalpara district. Yeah. And what is your take on that?
Actually, Suryapar is the very important monument under the ASI at Assam. That is considered to be the one among the worship place of sun. God in this region, and we are in Suryapar. We are getting three regional religion in a clutch,
right?
Like Buddhism, Jainism, and Brahminical. All sect of religion has developed together in this region. It was existed from early days to 17th and 18th century on till 17th and 18th century AD. Here in this at Suryapar, not only we are preserving the monuments of Brahminical, Jainism and Buddhism, we have conducted some excavations also at Suryapar that was revealed at monastery complex as well as the temple complex of Jaina as well as Buddhist sect. These are the important evidences we found in this region that was exhibited in our archaeological museum also. That is one among the best museums.
Absolutely.
In the
here I would like to tell you that we also visited the museum and found it to be very well kept. And do you have such kind of museums elsewhere also?
Yeah, we are all over India. We are having 45 museums controlling by the ASI, but in northeast we are having only one museum at Suryapar that was well maintained. We are further, we are going to extend the display also. We are under process to carry out how the display can be improved and further how can we elaborate the things we found in the excavations to the people. The peoples are laymen, they are not in a position to understand what is excavation. They can able to understand, they have
yes,
to
awareness is necessary,
yeah, awareness
to understand
necessary.
It.
For that we are going to create an awareness and center also in this
and local people needs
information
to be
center. We are going to create an information center so that can able to guide the people to understand the site.
Yes, and interest of the local people is very much needed because without their engagement, the things cannot be done in proper way. Their engagement is necessary. In the Guwahati Circle, apart from Assam, you were also to take care of monuments of other states. Could you throw some light on that?
Yes, yes. Actually, apart from Assam, we are having four states under the control of Guwahati Circle, namely Arunachal, Nagaland and Meghalaya. These are basically Mengirs, we can call it as a Mengir, megalithic type of monuments in Meghalaya.
In stone carvings?
Yeah, stone. That is a stone Mengirs. That stone is one kind of a megalithic practice existed in the
megalithic
in the in the prehistoric period.
That
is protohistoric. In between prehistory and historical period, there is protohistoric period. Here it is in little bit late date of Mengirs, as well as some structural remains found in Arunachal, like Bispaknagar, that is maintained by the Archaeological Survey of India, as well as another important archaeological site is Balukpum, is there Bhalukpum under the control also. Of Archaeological Survey of India.
Okay, there are some bodies from the state governments also who support you, or they
work state in tandem with you? Other than ASI, state archaeology from Assam, the government has having so many monuments under their control. They are also doing well conserve and preserve methods. We are giving some assistance to them whenever they required for technical support. They are also together, we are working together with state government as well as ASI with so many projects.
Exactly. Actually, Assam is a place of the reference of Assam is found even in the Mahabharata.
Yes.
And the other day when I was talking to you, you said that there is a very interesting, you know, monuments in southern Assam also, in places in like in the Barak Valley, Silchar and adjoining areas from Kohima to, you know, a trail of the Kacharis can be traced. Can you
another important dynasty we can say in our northeast is Kachar. Kachari kings. They once established their kingdom at Dimapur. They slowly driven away from Dimapur and migrated to Meibang. From Meibang to there, shifted to Kachar now.
I think Khashpur is the place.
Khashpur is the place. This is the separate distinguished king of local kingdom of this region.
Do you have any specific monuments?
Yeah, we are having the monuments. Three places we are having the monuments regarding that Kachars. One at Dimapur, we are having the monuments, as well as then Golaghat, there is a monument is there, our district.
And in Khashpur also?
Khashpur also, we are having the monument. And Meibang, there is a stone temple is there. These are the important monuments of Kachar.
Okay, okay. So nice to know that. Now, you know, there are certain section of people, or not only among the common people, there's a feeling that there are a lot of temples which are in a very dilapidated condition, monuments which are not in good shape. Archaeological Survey of India might take up those. And what is the criteria of taking up, and how do you go about it?
Most of the temples here under control of ASI was notified during the British periods.
Okay.
That is under the control of ASI till date. Right. That was notified due to its importance.
I see.
Importance that has been notified.
Okay.
Besides, so many monuments or temples are available in region.
Okay.
But entire thing we are not in a position to take over and maintain.
Okay.
If the state government willing to hand over, as well as the district administration willing to hand over to ASI, so that will, the proposal will be considered by the director general level.
Okay. There is a process.
Yeah, process.
Because that you people take, belong that, to that the Ministry
process,
of Culture.
That will take process.
Yeah.
So then we will take over and we can able to maintain. So that could be able to maintain.
Yeah, because Archaeological Survey of India is part of Ministry of Culture.
Yes, yes.
And there is a process through which you have to go
We have to take over the thing. Without doing this, we can't able to attend the work on that.
So, like when I was preparing for this program, basically, and I felt that there was an excavation at Ambari in Guwahati.
Yes, yes.
And there was a lot of speculation.
Actually,
There was a lot of expectation from that excavation.
Actually,
but nothing has been heard of late. Regarding that,
Ambari excavation starts in the year 1969, and it was continued up to 2008. It was five times excavated by excavators like great Dr. R.D. Chaudhary, as well as Dr. R.S.K. Manjul. They are excavated the Ambari site basically to know the antiquity of Guwahati. The site was taken up for excavations. Guwahati is the one of the important ancient city,
absolutely,
but we don't have any historical evidence till date. The reason is this was the continuous settlement. There is no space available to dig and identify the historicity of that Guwahati. Here, there is no space available to find out the historicity of Guwahati.
Right.
So, what are the small area found in the near the Goli Pukri?
Right.
That area was excavated, and we found there brick tank with steps, and there Nadaraja sculptures as well as Mahishasuramardhini sculptures, like in Brahminical theme of sculptures we found. From that we can say this may be a ancient Guwahati.
Right. And before coming to Northeast, you were doing very well out there in Tamil Nadu, I suppose.
Yes, yes. Actually, before coming to Guwahati, I was worked in Bangalore excavation branch. During that time, I was conducted 2-season excavation at Keeladi. Now it is getting a very famous site in Tamil Nadu that belongs to Sangam age of
Sangam
200 age. BC.
Okay.
That was discovered, and now that excavation also continuing by state archaeology, and so many evidences are found regarding the great civilization of that region.
Absolutely. So it seems that your experience will help the archaeological scenario in Northeast to prosper in the coming days.
Yeah, definitely we are ready to work all over India. Then only we can able to know the different cultural patterns.
Absolutely.
India is the multicultural site, having its own cultural value. We have to give respect to that culture and get the evidence of their individual cultural material, so we can show that our multicultural plurality in the India.
And the evolution of mankind cannot be complete without studying the past.
One can be
futuristic,
definitely,
but the base is always the past.
Yes, yes.
So, viewers, hopefully you liked our interaction with Mr. Amarnath, our superintending archaeologist of Guwahati Circle. Thank you, sir, for coming to the studios and having an insight into our past of Northeast and also of India. Past is important, so is future. As we move from past to future, We keep on coming to you, and in the next week, in the coming weeks, we'll be having lots of new topics for you. So till then, bye-bye and have a nice time.